गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज श्रुति मैम, मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल, न्यू एरिया, नवादा। टुडे इज वेडनेसडे, सो वन चैप्टर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एंड सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज अ ट्रूली ब्यूटिफुल माइंड। दिस चैप्टर इज ऑन अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन। All of we know that Albert Einstein was a Nobel laureate and a great scientist. But when he was born, was there any such indication that he is going to be a great person? No. But on the other hand, that he was not even like the other ordinary children also. So that a truly beautiful mind, this chapter we will divide into two parts. In the first video, I will explain about Einstein's student life, early life, and second video, next part, I will discuss on Einstein's that later life, his love life, his working life. Later life. So Einstein was born on 14th March 1879 in the city Ulm in Germany. When he was born, he was a very common child, and his mother observed that his head is a little bit large than other children, and two hours and six months he did not speak, he could not speak, and he started speaking after that, and most of the time he did not play with other children, he could not understand what to do with the children, with his fellow other children. So that's why the children used to tell her that brother boring. Why brother boring? Because he was not able to play with them. When Einstein's headmaster told his father that it is not necessary to be worried about what the profession Einstein is going to choose in future, because he would not be able to successful in any profession. So how humiliating these words are, means everybody around Einstein, they had a very poor opinion about Einstein. At the age of 16, Einstein began to learn violin because her mother wanted that. He learned violin very nicely, and he could play very nicely. And throughout his life, he was a very good amateur violinist. Amateur means that it was not his profession. He liked to play violin. Whatever. Einstein was a good student also. People also. Pupil. P-U-P-I-L. Pupil means student. He was a very good student also. And in Munich, in German, in Munich, he joined school, and he started studying over there. And he scored very good marks over there. But he was not able to cope up with the discipline of the school. It was almost suffocating to him. He decided to leave the school. Naturally, when any student try to leave the school, naturally guardians and other person, they will not allow. After a prolonged discussion, at the age of 15, Einstein discussed. Einstein just got the took the decision that he had to change the school, and he went to Milan. That is a German speaking Switzerland. That is a city where the language was German, and it was originally in Switzerland. And actually, that previous year, that year Einstein went there, previous year Einstein's parents shifted to that place, and Einstein was left to the relatives. So Einstein went over there, and in Milan he took admission, and there he was doing very good. And after the completion of the school life, he took admission in the university in Zurich, and there he was highly gifted in mathematics, and he was very much interested in physics. So in the university Zurich, he started studying over there, and that time Einstein was a young man, and he was not only interested in mathematics and physics, he was a very good looking young man, and he had a walrus mustache. Walrus mustache means I will keep the photo over there, means the stylish mustache. And he was looking very much attractive. So Einstein had interest in other things also. That in that university Zurich, there came one lady, Miss that was Mileva, and that Einstein was interested in Mileva also, and both of them had fallen in love. And you should learn that though they were in love, but they did not ignore their study. Rather, they could improve their study at the same time. Einstein was they were studying both mathematics, physics, other science subjects, and that theory of relativity. And Einstein was just used to say that he was just thinking himself very much proud, very much gifted, because when he with Mileva, when both of them will be able to just study that relativity theory, and both they will be able to improve that. So it was a very good opportunity, and it would be a very great achievement for both of them. So that up to here today, and next video, second video, I will just complete this chapter. Already I have sent the syllabus. And here the title is, the name of the topic is A Truly Beautiful Mind. That Einstein was not only a very great scientist, not only a Nobel laureate. Truly beautiful mind means that during that his time, that several disasters happened, world war, and that the destruction of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and Einstein was very much hurt by those incidents. And as he was a great person, he was a worldwide known person, he tried to stop all these matters, and he gave his opinion against all these massacres against humanity. He was a very good humanitarian also. So that's why the name of your topic is A Truly Beautiful Mind. So thank you everybody. Stay at home. Stay safe.